you're running Facebook or Instagram advertising, you're going to want to use custom audiences at some point. For all the clients that I run advertising for, we use custom audiences in each and every one of their campaigns. These audiences are super powerful, not just to optimize your budget or ad spend, but also the overall performance of your advertising campaigns. So without further ado, let's get to it. Welcome back to my channel. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to use and how to set up Facebook custom audiences. Also, in future videos, we'll take a look at saved audiences and lookalike audiences. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and notification bell to get updates when those videos go live. Also, make sure you stick it out until the end of the video because I'll show you exactly how to get access to my free Facebook advertising crash course. Before diving into today's topic, I just want to make sure that you know that Instagram is owned by Facebook. So if you're planning on running ads on Instagram, you'll actually have to go through the Facebook Business Manager. And in total, Facebook and Instagram allow you to create three different types of audiences. First, there's a saved audience, then we have custom audiences, which we're talking about today, and then we have lookalike audiences. And just to give you a short introduction as to what those different types of audiences look like, here's a little overview. A saved audience is an audience based on demographics, interests, or behaviors. So this is an audience that you can create in Facebook based on characteristics that you know or believe your target audience has, such as age, location, profession, interests, hobbies, life events, etc. A custom audience, on the contrary, are people who have already shown some sort of interest in you or your business. So they may have watched your videos on YouTube or social media, they may have visited your website, signed up to your newsletter, bought from you online, and so on. Then lastly, we have lookalike audiences. A lookalike audience is an audience based on an already existing custom audience. And then Facebook will, as the word suggests, create an audience that looks like your audience. So for example, let's say you have an already existing custom audience that has people in it that have already bought from you. A lookalike audience based on that audience will then exist of people who are most likely to also buy from you. So today we're tackling Facebook custom audiences, so the people that have already in some way or form shown interest in you or your brand. I'm gonna open up my laptop and show you what options you have and how you can start using these audiences to your advantage today.
Okay, so guys, I'm gonna show you how to set up one of those custom audiences, and I'm in my Business Manager, and what you wanna do is you're gonna click on the left top hand corner where it says Business Manager, or it might say Ads Manager, doesn't really matter, just click on it. And then go to the assets column and click on the audiences button. And when that loads, it will show you all the audiences that I have already created. So these are all the audiences that I have already created. And to create a new audience, you're gonna click the create audience button, and that will give you a drop down that will show you the three types of audiences that we just discussed. So the custom audience, lookalike audience, and saved audience. And for this tutorial, we're going to focus on the custom audience. So go ahead and click that one, and that will open up a pop-up. So once again, a custom audience is an audience based on people who have already in some way or form shown interest in your business or your brand. And so that can have happened in various ways. And that's also why Facebook allows us to use different sources to build our audience. So for example, we can use people who have visited our website, and this is where the pixel comes in. Or we can use a customer list, for example, an email list, offline activity, people who have visited our stores. If we have an app, we can target people who use that app or haven't used it in a while, which is also interesting. Then Facebook also allows Facebook sources to be used as the base of your audience. So for example, if you've uploaded a video on your page or as advertising, you can then make an audience based on people who have watched a certain amount of that video. You can then also use your Instagram business profile. So if you do have a business profile on Instagram, you can create an audience of people who visited or interacted with your profile on Instagram. Then lead forms is a certain type of advertising that you can use on Facebook, where people can submit their contact information directly through the ad. Now, if someone would have interacted with that advertising, for example, they started typing but didn't submit it, you can still retarget those people if you use this source as the base of your audience. Events is for people who have interacted with your events page on Facebook. Instant experience is another type of advertising on Facebook. Again, you can use people who have interacted with this advertising as a base source for your audience. And then your Facebook page. So as you can see, you have so many options, and in my course I actually dive into all of these, but for this tutorial we're just gonna focus on the website because that's the one that most people will be using. So just click on that one. And then we're gonna go step by step. So first they ask you to add people to your audience. And important is that they ask you, do you wanna include people who meet any of the following criteria or all of the following criteria. And for me, I'm gonna click all. If you click any, for example, if you have multiple pages that you wanna target, if they have landed on one of those pages, they will be included. As I will be excluding people and stuff like that, I just wanna make sure that they match all of the criteria. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a custom audience of all of the people that have visited my website in the last 30 days, except for the people that have already bought, because I don't want to spam them with my advertising. So I'm going to create an audience where automatically Facebook can add and exclude the right people. So what we're going to do is we're going to use my active pixel for my website. If you have one pixel, it will just show your one pixel. If you have multiple, click the arrow and it will show you the drop down. So for me, I'm going to click this one. And then I'm going to say all website visitors in the past 30 days. I could do it like that just to show you what this can also, what more possibilities this offers for you. Is I'm going to click on the drop down. And there you will see that you can click all website visitors, people who have visited specific pages, visitors by time spent, or if you have Pixel Events installed like I have, you can choose one of those. If you choose people who visited specific pages, they will show you a URL box, and you will then have to fill out which URL you mean, and you can then say that it just contains that part of the URL, it doesn't contain that part of the URL, or it equals the complete URL. So I'll show you how that works when I exclude people. So for this part, I just want all website visitors. I want everyone who's visited my website in the last 30 days. And then you could click further narrow, which allows you to add something else. So I want this, and then I want that, which I'm not gonna use right now, but again, it works the same way. It's the same drop-downs. You just select what you need to build your audience. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna exclude people. So I want everyone who visited my website, except for the people that landed on the thank you page, because I know if they landed on a thank you page, they have registered or bought something. So what we're gonna do is people who visited specific web pages, we're gonna select that one. And then instead of typing the full URL, which would be yogurtsurf.com/product name/, I'm not going to do that. I know that all the pages where people would have landed after they registered or bought have thank you in it. So I'm just going to write /thank you, because I know that this means they have registered. This will be different for your website maybe. If you're not sure, you can just enter all the exact URLs that you want to exclude. I just know for my website that this will be sufficient. So now we have all website visitors except for the people that registered or bought, which is perfect because I don't want to keep targeting those people with my offer that they've already registered for. So then we're just going to say custom. I do it like this just to remember which one is a custom audience, which one is a lookalike. And we're gonna say all visitors 30 days excluding buy. Let's do it like that. And then all you have to do is click create audience. And it says your custom audience was created. It may take a few minutes for us to finish matching your customers to people on Facebook. We'll notify you when this process is finished. You can also check the status in the audience manager. Because now Facebook has to go back 30 days and check all the people that visited my website and then find them on Facebook. They will also ask you immediately, do you want to create a lookalike audience based on this custom audience? Or do you want to create an ad? In this tutorial, we're not gonna go deeper into this, but in the next one, we are going to create a lookalike audience, so make sure that you tune in next week. And then just click done, and as you can see, it's right there, and it also says for the size that it is still populating.
That's it, I hope that was helpful for you. If you have questions, just leave them in the comments below and I will make sure to get back to you. Also, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and make sure you check the link in the description if you want to get access to that free Facebook advertising crash course. That's it for this tutorial. I wish you a very, very fulfilling week. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.